Hi children, we have seen in our classes lots of separation technique and fractional distillation of air and purification of drinking water which we drink, isn't it? Now we can see a very simple topic today, physical and chemical changes. On moving to our topic, physical and chemical changes. You have studied that physical and chemical, about this physical and chemical changes there in smaller classes. We can see the points one by one. Okay, so first point we have seen in smaller classes were, what was the first point? Yes, physical changes happening to physical properties. If changes for a material is happening to its physical properties only, then we will call that as physical change. Okay, during a physical change, change happens only for the physical properties. Physical properties will change the. Okay, whereas in a chemical change, what is happening? First we can see all the points of physical change. After that we can see the chemical changes. Okay, so physical properties such as shape, color, size, isn't it? State, all these will change during a physical change. For that we can take one example. If you are folding a paper, is it a physical or chemical change? We are changing the size, isn't it? Not happening any changes to its properties there. Only that physical size is only changing the. No other chemical properties are changing the. It is paper, still we can write there, isn't it? So only changes happening to its physical properties. So we can include it in the physical change. Boiling of water. It is physical change, isn't it? We can condense that water vapors back to water, isn't it? So all these are temporary changes. We can say that the second point, physical changes are temporary change. Temporary changes. Physical changes are temporary changes. It is happening for a limited time period. After that, it will change, that it will change back to its original. Okay, temporary change. So physical change is a temporary change, and we can bring after application of that force or whatever we are applying there to make that change, after removing that force or that thing, we can come back, take it back to its original position. If you are stretching a rubber band there, after removing that force we are applied the, we have applied the, we can bring back that rubber band to its normal form, isn't it? So physical changes, a change happening to its physical properties only, and temporary change, it is a temporary change. And we can say that during a physical change, no new substances are produced the. No new substances are produced there during a physical change. If you are boiling water there, only you will get water vapor. Is it a new thing? No, water is changing into physical state, isn't it? So only that physical state is changing, nothing new is produced there. And for the physical change to happen, there involved a little amount of energy. Either we can during that process, energy will be absorbed or released in the form of heat or light. That will be very small quantity, small amount of energy conversions are involved. Small amount of energy is required. That is in the form, it can be in the form of heat or light, whatever there, whatever may be that form of energy, but its quantity, the amount required is very less, very small for the conversion of physical change, for the for physical change to happen. Okay, so these are the points of physical changes. Physical change, during that physical change, changes happening to physical properties only, and these physical changes are temporary changes, and then no new substances are produced, and a small amount of energy is involved during that physical change. Sometimes energy will be absorbed or sometimes energy will be liberated out. And one more point we can say, physical changes are reversible. Physical changes are reversible. Reversible physical changes, we can bring it back to its original form. That is why we can say that physical changes are reversible. Example, we can say that stretching rubber band, boiling water, folding paper, all these are different examples for physical changes. Okay, now we can see what are the points in chemical changes. Okay, one by one we can see. If you are taking that chemical change, the first point we can say changes are happening there to the physical as well as chemical properties. Both physical and both the properties will change there. Both the properties change. During a chemical change, physical as well as chemical properties are changing there. Okay, for example, the same piece of paper, we can burn it. That time what you are observing, the can we write on that ash? No, we cannot. A new material is produced with a new property. So, entire properties are changing during that chemical change. Then we can say, is it a permanent change or temporary change? It is permanent change. So, chemical change is a permanent change. We cannot bring it back. Okay, it has happened there. We cannot convert that ash back to paper. So, that has happened there. It is a permanent change. And in that case, chemical change, new substances. From the paper, we got ash. Isn't it? So, new substances are produced there. Okay, then if you are talking about energy involved for burning the piece of paper, lot of energy is required, isn't it? Large quantities of energy is involved, either absorption or evolution in the form of heat or light, whatever may be, amount of energy required is large there. And finally, we can say that chemical changes are irreversible and we cannot bring it back to its original form. That is why we can say that chemical changes are irreversible changes. And we can see examples for chemical changes. More examples for chemical changes we can see. Cooking of food. If we after cooking we are getting a new substance we are getting there, isn't it? Initially we will be taking the raw vegetables and all. So after cooking we are getting new taste and all new material. Then another example, burning of paper. Okay, then budding of flower. Can we bring that flower back to bud? No, it's not possible. So all these are different examples of chemical changes. So once again we can see the points of chemical and physical changes. During that chemical change, physical change, only physical properties changes, but in the case of chemical change, both physical and chemical properties will change together. And physical change is a temporary change, whereas chemical change is a permanent change. And during that physical change, no new substances are produced there, but in a physical chemical change, new substances are produced there. And in small amount of energy is required for that physical change to happen, but in the case of chemical change, large amount of energy is required there. And physical change is reversible and chemical change is irreversible, and these are some of the examples of physical and chemical changes. Understood? Now I have a question to you. Can a physical and a chemical change occur together? Yes, you have studied it. Burning of candle is such an example, isn't it? So during that time, melting of wax, that is known as physical change. During that, solid is converted into liquid. But the wick is burning, that burning process is the chemical change. The during that time, that is completely changing into carbon dioxide and water vapor and all. So burning of candle is an example in which both physical and chemical changes taking place together. Can you cite one more example for such a change in which both the changes are taking place together? Burning of LPG. During the burning of LPG, what is happening there? In the cylinder, it is kept in liquid form. LPG, liquefied petroleum gas, right? So, when we are opening that nozzle there, burner nozzle there, it is passing through the, from the cylinder through that tube it is coming. So, that pressure is reduced there, that liquid will change into gas. So, a physical change is happening there, and then when we are burning it, there chemical change is also happening. So, certain cases are there where both the physical and chemical changes are taking place together. Okay, hope this much is clear to you. Thank you.